Hi friends, this is Rakesh from Let's Make Learning Simple channel. Now we are going to discuss about Singleton Design Pattern practical implementation, or we can say it as a simple or basic implementation of Singleton Design Pattern. In the previous video, we would have seen the theoretical and real-time examples for Singleton Pattern. If suppose if you haven't watched that video, please try to watch that video and then come to this video for better understanding. So here I have created two classes, Singleton class and Singleton main. Singleton main is used to call that Singleton Design Pattern class. So our focus is this class. So here there are four steps involved for creating the Singleton, for implementing the Singleton Design Pattern. The first step is we need to define the Singleton object as static and private. So private means private access modifier, so that this object cannot be accessed directly from the outside classes. If you want to access this class, then you need the support from the, you need to access from the methods. So that's the first step. So you need to define it as a private and also as static. And then second step is you need to create the constructor as a private constructor. If you have n number of constructors, then you should make those constructors as private, so that you cannot access to these constructors from outside class. If I am uncommenting this line, then you would see the following error: Singleton constructor as private access in Singleton. So we can't access the private constructors from the outside class. So this is the second step. And the third step is you need to create a static method to get instance. So this is the static method, public static. The return type is this class name and get instance. Using this method, you can get the object of this class. So this is the important part. This is the if check. It will check whether the object for this static class is static object is created or not. For the first time, the singleton would be null. Singleton object would be null. So this if check would be passed and it will execute this line. So for the first time, the singleton object would be created using private constructor. You would have a doubt regarding the private constructor. You would have doubt, right? The private constructor cannot be accessed from the outside class, but how it can be accessed from the within the class? Yes, we can access the private constructors within the class. The reason behind it is we can access the private methods within the class. Similarly, we can access private constructors within the same class. So we are by using that principle, we are accessing the private constructor and we are creating the object for the first time. If the method was called for the second time, then it will check for the null check. At that time, the singleton wouldn't be null. It would have some object. So this if check would give false, so this step won't be executed, so it will directly return the already created object. So now this is the first step, we need to declare the object as private and static, and then second step private constructor, third step we need to create a static method to get the instance. The fourth step is we need to get the object using this get instance method. The name for this method would be anything. It can be get instance or get object, get new instance, anything. So by using this method, for the first time, what would happen is it will go to this step. It will check whether it is null or not. It is null for the first time, so that it uses the private constructor. It will create the object. It will return that object. Similarly, for the second time, it comes to here. Since the object is already created, it will skip these steps and it will directly return this singleton object, already created object. So only one object was created and that object was returned for the n number of times. So even if you create n number of reference variables, the only one object would be created. By using those objects, we are trying to call this a display method. If you run this program, you would see the following output. I have called using singleton object. So thanks for watching this video. At the end of this video, you will see the channel icon here. Please click on that for subscribing the channel.